Welcome back to Sailing Ruby Rose in Saigon. Just for everyone's knowledge, it is the 1st of July today. I am back. I've been away for 2 weeks and you had some boat reviews. Some of you love them. Some of you are like, ah, I want to just see the boat being built. So this, for those of you who want to see boat building, is what we're going to do today. There is a lot to show you in this factory. Over there, there is a 1600 because now they've moved the production of the 1600 into this facility. Behind me, there are four hulls now. Over there, there are three hardtops, and hull one now has the carbon coach roof, the deck and the hull all in situ, and fit out has started on that. The deck mold over there is for hull two, and that will be going on in the next couple of weeks. So much to see. Keep watching, you can enjoy this one. Have a look to see what they're doing with Ruby Rose. So what we have, obviously there's some skin fittings going through there, some little outlets. We now have the emergency hatches. So let's do the big reveal. This is what this boat looks like with the hardtop on. Now this is hull one, but I'm going to show you a real detailed look today at what everything is going to look like. We've got a lot of patron questions, and I'm going to get hold of Mike in next week's episode and get all those answers. So we've got so many detailed questions from our patrons regarding the absolute specifics, the sizes, headrooms, and we're going to get all those answered. But first, let's go and take a look at exactly what this boat is going to look like with the three constituent components in place. Let's go and take a look. So, firstly, let's look at this hardtop in place. There's obviously no headliner thing. Let's just concentrate first on the size of the hardtop. Now, something that we have been asked by a lot of our patrons is exactly how much of an overhang and how far this overhang comes back over the stern. So let us actually just have a look there. I will come back with a tape measure and do that, but I think that as I look at this, what we have is literally the transom there, and I would say that this extends back probably a good meter 50. That's 3-4 foot. That's huge. And then just to pan around, I think there's so much to see this morning. Looking at all this, one thing just to show you. When you're asking for progress, you can see the red and the blue are plumbing lines. So they've obviously started the interior fit out here. My impression is just the volume, the amount of space they have here. It's huge. Now, these aren't the actual windows. So probably a lot of you are going to say, well, it's very dark, but they are just mock-ups. So there is no light coming through into that saloon at all. But let me go and take a good look with you all. I'm just going to try and get James. So now we have an engine hatch cover, which again, that's interesting to see because there's side opening. Just have a little look, just run past James's feet there. So we've got side opening engine access. Super interesting. Moving forward, these are obviously mock-ups of the bulkheads. And again, it gives us a really good idea of the size of the trifold door when it's open. The design of this is kind of similar to the 1260. Trifold door and then these two big windows. But these windows are considerably bigger than those on the 1260. So these will obviously be electrically operated. And then we also now, this is something we could not see before, get a really good idea of the size of the hatches. Also interestingly, nice to see a couple of Harken winches. For those kleptomaniacs amongst you, are they in place? Woohoo! Actually, they are. So that, yes. For those of you who are into winches, I'm not sure. Well, I guess anyone who sails is into winches. They are pretty little winches. Clutches are now in place, so we can actually see small details like the angle. They obviously thought all this out to make sure that there is no chap points. So again, the angulation of this as all the lines come through this captive system. Let's look at the transom. So again, something else we can see, the actual size of the transom settee. Now there's obviously going to be a stainless bar around there, but interesting, super interesting. See, You've got quite a big sofa there. We can now see the size of the area for the barbecue. Again, super big. Gas locker. And we are just gonna take a look on the starboard side. Now, stanchions, for those of you who watched our episode filmed up in Hanoi with Midway, you can see exactly the quality of the stainless here. So I'm just trying to move out of the way because there's a guy just trying to put the deck hatch on for the engine cover, so that's gonna go there. And then moving forward, again, stanchions. Stanchions in place, small details. And again, we did all this with Midway, but I'm just gonna pull this up. And again, the quality of the stainless steel, look at those joints, there is not a single weld visible. Look, little things, all of you, when you go to boat shows, look at the quality of the welds. That is now a yardstick for how well something is built. Ooh, ooh, how can this be so appealing? It's not normal, not right, and not natural. Okay, moving forward, enough. Put these clothes back on. Okay, moving forward, what do we have? We have stanchions. So that's just something super interesting to see, that, you know, the quality of the work there. But obviously something that a lot of people have asked you about is the dolphin watching seats. Again, beautiful. They are fiberglass. Some people want these in teak, but I think that in a catamaran where you're going to get so much water over these, they need to be made in fiberglass. And again, some real nice work to the push pit. And you can kind of see, again, just the angulation of the other side. There's a lot to see there, but I just want to spin this around. And a lot of people have asked about the angulation of the uprights. And this, as you can see, is all in carbon fiber. So you have another lightweight structure. Windows will go in there. You can also see exactly where the mast depth is going to be. And then what we have is this whole carbon coachroof, of which this is why this boat can take 2 kilowatts of solar, because the coachroof is just so large. And between flexible and fixed mounted panels, you have so much. And little things, steps, little recesses, gutters, all these things that, from our point of view, will make almost the perfect cruising catamaran. There has been so much going on, and I'm just going to pan around because some of you are like, oh, what's going on in that factory? There's nothing going on there. I want to show you, like, this view, because if you're into boat building, this is pretty impressive. So let me just go. Over here in that bay, over there, there is carbon coachroof 3, 4, 2, 1 is over there. In this bay, there are all the stainless components for hole 1. Screw sizes as to be defined by the architectural drawings. But then panning around again, hole 2, Ruby Rose, hole 3, hole 4 in the distance. Amazing, just this whole production line. Back there, we have the deck mold. Over there, 1600. So much work being going on elsewhere around the factory on small and different aspects of the whole Seawind production. So there, I can see just in the distance over there, there is one of the helm stations for the 1600, I believe, the helm pedestal. So yeah, super interesting. So the exterior, a tour of the exterior of Hull 1 Seawind 1370. Come back next week and we are going to do a full tour of the interior and show you all the developments inside. So I really hope you like that. I am super happy to be back in Ho Chi Minh. Not overly impressed at the amount I'm sweating, but hey, that's probably too much information for you guys. Anyway, hope you enjoyed that. Someone's angle guiding. I'll be back next week. Give us a like, give us a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel if you're into boat building and sailing, and I will see you all again soon. Take care, goodbye.